thing.
You need to do it right now. Come over here.
Regina Love. I'm telling you, man.
The show is about to begin, so we're going to bring up the sound on the TV in a second.
We are live here. Regina Love. She's getting ready to win this thing, all right? I'd like to thank everybody for tuning in. And just know, Regina Love. She's going to win this thing, I'm telling you, so you all.
I think we already
vote, 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 vote. Wmqg, EOTM Radio.
With their battle approaching, Jordan and Regina.
Having them behind us really added a lot more energy, and Regina really fed off of that. And she was like, in my face, and I was like,
there was one line at the very beginning, Regina.
That line. Totally agree with it.
Mm-hmm. Jordan, the second time you did, when it was high, it was fuller. Mm-hmm. And the first time it was a little bit thinner. Keep it full, as much as possible.
I'm just blown away that you can go up there with such good, you obviously know what you're doing. And you hit that, and it's just, that's a weapon, you know. It's pow!
Adam has a hell of a difficult choice there. Two of them together is a match.
There is a lot of questions about yourself. She's a powerhouse. But I think it's very important for me to just be confident in my own abilities. I am different, and I want this to be a pivotal moment for me that I can look back on and be proud of.
Hi, guys.
You look good.
Thank you, man. You guys excited?
Yeah, I'm really excited.
I'm excited.
You're both two of the best singers I know, so just have fun. The rest is easy. Hard part's over.
I'll be your biggest cheerleader out there.
All right.
Biggest shaved-headed cheerleader in the fucking band.
Special for completely different reasons, but I gotta go with what I feel winner of this battle is Jordan.
Jordan's gonna win. YouTube, make sure you look at it and like it. But she said, you know, God made me push this button. And you know, people don't confess or profess their Christianity or anything. But she said, I'm in tears. And God just took my hand and just said, God made me push this button. So I just thank God for her and everybody else, because you know, you guys know this is a TV show. Okay? But we know the real, and we know who is over all us. So I ask you guys to please tell people to follow me at I Am Regina Love. That's my Twitter, and my Instagram is I Am Regina Love. My Facebook is Regina Love. You guys, each one, reach one. And together, we can do this and make this happen. All right? I'm telling you. I know they think it one thing, but I'm going to tell you something. You know the Most High and God Almighty can take this thing and flip it and just amazing. And it's really amazing because with Pharrell, all the coaches, they're like, and I don't know if you guys heard, but Adam, he also said, he says, you know what, being around her, one part of the show, being around her, this girl changed my life. And that's what I'm here to do. I mean, it's wonderful that I'm on The Voice, but I'm here to let people know, it doesn't matter how old you are, how you look, what you've been through in your life, I don't care if you've been to prison, I don't care if you've been in 2-3 marriages. I don't care what has happened. But your dreams can and will come true. And that's the reason why I'm here on The Voice. Because people need to hear my story and everybody else's. Because if I can do it, so can you.
Yeah.
So this is what we have to do, guys. I need everybody. I need, there's no tweet too small, no tweet too big. To continue to do it daily. And they have iTunes. You have to get that Apple Music app or buy it from iTunes. You can get the Like I Can. It's already available. And also Rocksteady. Make sure you guys get that. And like all of the videos that is on iTunes. And like all of YouTube. And like all the things that they have to offer. Because all that counts. All of that counts. So you know how the social media game is right now, guys. And I had to learn how to do it. I'm 51 years old. And I ain't ashamed to tell it. I had to learn how to do all this stuff. And y'all know, I'm sitting there on the phone all day long, tweeting and this and that and answering. Because I want to answer my fans. I want them to know that it's really me that's answering them. I had people call me, tweet me from Honduras and Hungary. My Instagram is I Am Regina Love. And my Twitter is I Am Regina Love. And I have Periscope. I gotta be patient with you on that Periscope. I'm trying to learn that too. It's I Am Regina Love, Regina Love, Regina Love. I love you guys. And I will be leaving on October 26th to go back. So, you know what I'm saying, but I'm just saying, I'll be leaving to go back. Amen. Amen. So that's it. But just be between the lines.
Yeah.
Okay. Be between the lines. So I love you guys. So, but it ain't over, y'all.
It ain't
over. We gotta come together. We need the whole world, guys. And let's show them that together we can do this. I love you guys so much. Whatever I have, I'm going to give to her. And it's so funny because it's not only her, it's Pharrell and also Play. So God is giving me favor with all of the coaches.
That's right.
And that's amazing because when we get the chair term, you know, a lot of times they don't, you know, it has to be edited for, you know, television purposes. But he said, look, I've been waiting on a soul singer to do a rock song with. And I told him, I said, okay, you said it on national television. I said, we're going to hold you to that. Okay. And he also said, I can't wait to do the song. And Pharrell as well. So you know what? It's more to it than The Voice, guys. It's just the relationship that you make, the exposure that God allows you to bring. You just go at it. As long as you have that platform. And I'll tell you something, I'm going to be around a long time.
Hey!
But you guys,
all right,
hold up. The people that weren't in Hollywood, they need to be enlightened. Tell us about how it went down. When did you go?
I went February 14th was my audition day in Atlanta, Georgia on Valentine's Day. And it was cold. I mean, I was in line. I'm not gonna lie, I had a black underneath coat on to the fall. And I looked like a superstar. And my husband was with me. And his And we were in line, and people were looking at us, and I'm standing right there with them too. And it's a lot of kids, like these are young kids. These are 16 and 15 and then 20, some 30, but hey, I'm, like I said, I'm 51 and I'm standing proud.
That's right.
Okay. So by the time we got in here, I'm telling you, they had everything down to a science. It's like the rows, thousands and thousands and thousands. 85,000 people try out to be a part of the voice. And from 85,000, they only chose 100. And then our group was the least group because before they even went to the first elimination, they had already cut two people, which brought it down to 98. But it was amazing. When I went in to do the first audition, they had groups of 15. Each room had groups of 15. So you guys know how big the apparel mart is. So they had a whole apparel mart from top to bottom, groups of 15. And so she said, I asked the guy to hear, here's my name, put mine on the bottom because I don't want to be this. You know, I gave it to the guy. Because I know you don't know first. So, but I want to see what I got against. You know what I'm saying? So she said, okay, everybody sit down. So the first name I'm going to call is Regina Love. I mean, where was I with? And I sang, and she was like, okay, wow, thank you. So they clapped, and everybody else went. And she gave a spiel. She said, you know, I just want to tell everybody, we thank you guys for coming, and we thank you guys for trying out. But she said, you know, a lot of times, if we don't call your name, it does not mean that you're not good. It does not mean that, you know, you should do something else. But, you know, it just means that we're looking for something else. So we want to thank you because if it wasn't for you, we would not have a show. So when I call the names, I want you to come to the front. And so she said, the first name I'm going to call is Regina Love. And then I walked to the front and she said, thank you everybody so much for coming. We will see you next year.
All right, hold on. That's a good answer. All right, so question number two that everybody here wants to know. Question number two. Are you married? No. We know she's married after married. But check this out. When you got there, question number six for you. When that chair spun, were you looking? When the chair spun around, did you know who spun first?
You know what? I was engrossed in the song and I was looking at the audience because I like to engage with my audience. I think I did see Adam turn.
Yeah.
I saw him turn. And then I just kept going. I said, thank you, Lord, that's one.
Okay, good. That's a good answer. And when Adam turned and then Blake turned, you pretty much knew who you were going to go with, right?
No, I didn't.
You did?
Okay. No, because I really wanted to go with Pharrell. And
good answer.
And it was funny because when the song was over, my family was in the back and was like, he was dancing so much. And it was like, the song at the finish, he was like getting ready to hit it, and it was over. And he was like, ah, dang, 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 and he didn't show that. And he like fell out of the chair, and he talked for like a minute and 45 seconds. And Blake was like, okay, we turned our chairs. Can you give us a chance to speak? He said, well, I didn't have time. And that's when Blake said, what do you mean you didn't have time? We had a minute and 30 seconds to turn around. And that's when they were arguing. So
that's all the stuff we didn't see on TV. All right, here's what I love. When Blake turned that chair around, he basically looked over at you and went, Regina, I love you. How many of y'all love Regina tonight?
Yay!
Because she is Regina Love.
What did you say?
I said, when Blake turned his chair around, and he was first to go, he was like, Regina, I love
you. She's going to give to me whatever I have, I'm going to give to her. And it's so funny because it's not only her, it's Pharrell. And that's amazing because when we get the chair turn, you know, a lot of times they don't, you know, it has to be edited for, you know, television purposes. But he said, look, I've been waiting on a soul singer to do a rock song with. And I told him, I said, okay, you said it on national television. I said, we're going to hold you to that. Okay. And he also said, I can't wait to do the song. And Pharrell as well. So you know what? It's more to it than the voice, guys. It's just the relationship that you make, the exposure that God allows you to bring, you just go at it as long as you have that platform. And I'll tell you something, I'm going to be around a long time.
Hey!
But you got it.
All right, hold up. For the people that weren't in Hollywood, they need to be enlightened. Tell us about how it went down. Right, when did you go?
I went February 14th was my audition day in Atlanta, Georgia, on Valentine's Day. And it was cold. I mean, I was in line. I'm not gonna lie, I had a black diamond coat on to the wall. And I looked like a superstar. And my husband was with me. And we were in line, and people were looking at us, and I'm standing right there with them too. And it's a lot of kids, like these are young kids. These are 16 and 15 and then 20, some 30, but hey, I'm, like I said, I'm 51 and I'm standing proud.
That's right.
Okay. So by the time we got in here, I'm telling you, they had everything down to a science. It's like the rows, thousands and thousands and thousands. 85,000 people tried out to be a part of the voice. And from 85,000, they only chose 100. And then our group was the least group because before they even went to the first elimination, they had already cut two people, which brought it down to 98. But it was amazing. When I went in to do the first audition, they had groups of 15. Each room had groups of 15. So you guys know how big the apparel mart is. So they had a whole apparel mart from top to bottom, groups of 15. And so she said, I asked the guy to hear, here's my name, put mine on the bottom because I don't want to be this. You know, I gave it to the guy. Because I know you don't know what first. So, because I want to see what I've gone against. You know what I'm saying? So she said, okay, everybody sit down. So the first name I'm going to call is Regina Love. I mean, whatever. So I went and I sang, and she was like, okay, wow, thank you. So they clapped, and everybody else went. And she gave us a spiel. She said, you know, I just want to tell everybody, we thank you guys for coming, and we thank you guys for trying hard. But she said, you know, a lot of times, if we don't call your name, it does not mean that you're not good. It does not mean that, you know, you should do something else. But, you know, it just means that, we're looking for something else. We want to thank you because if it wasn't for you, we would not have a show. So when I call the names, I want you to come to the front. And so she said, the first name I'm going to call is Regina Love. And then I walked to the front and she said, thank you everybody so much for coming. And we will see you next year.
All right, hold on. That's a good answer. All right, so question number two that everybody here wants to know. Question number two. Are you married? No. We know she's married after married. But check this out. When you got there, question number six for you. When that chair spun, were you looking? When the chair spun around, did you know who spun first?
You know what? I was engrossed in the song and I was looking at the audience because I like to engage with my audience. I think I did see that turn.
Yeah.
I saw him turn. And then I just kept going. I said, thank you, Lord, that's one.
Okay, good.
That's a good answer. And when Adam turned and then Blake turned, you pretty much knew who you were going to go with, right?
No, I didn't.
You did? Okay.
No, because I really wanted to go with Pharrell. And
good answer.
And it was funny because when the song was over, my family was in the back and was like, he was dancing so much. And it was like, the song. At the finish, he was like getting ready to hit it, and it was over. And he was like, dang. And he didn't show that. And he like fell out of the chair, and he talked for like a minute and 45 seconds. And Blake was like, okay, we turned our chairs. Can you give us a chance to speak? He said, well, I didn't have time. And that's when Blake said, what do you mean you didn't have time? We had a minute and 30 seconds to turn around. And that's when they were arguing. So
that's all the stuff we didn't see on TV. All right, here's what I love. When Blake turned that chair around, he basically looked over at you and went, Regina, I love you. How many of y'all love Regina tonight?
Yay!
Because she is Regina Love. I said, when Blake turned his chair around, and he was first to go, he was like, Regina, I love you.
Hey, this is Ron Anthony, EOTM Radio out of LA. We're in Atlanta, Wmqg. I'm here with my friend, the beautiful Regina Love.
Don't you just love it?
Yeah. Hey, you enjoying this?
I am enjoying it. I'm enjoying all this whole journey. I'm really enjoying it, Ron.
Wow, I am so proud of you.
I'm just so grateful, man.
Yes. And you know what? I wouldn't have missed this.
I know. Ron used to sing with me, guys. He can sing too, y'all. Yes.
But you know what? I'm so proud of you. And you know, I wouldn't have missed this for the world.
You know what, Ryan?
But you deserve it.
I thank God. I tell people all the time when I'm doing interviews, I'm not doing this for me. I'm doing this also for me and my dreams, but I'm doing this for the people that thought that their life was over when they reached a certain age, thought that because they've gone through divorce, a single parent, or they may have even been incarcerated or anything may have happened to them in their life, that their life was over. But it ain't over, I'm telling you right
and
now.
And that's your song we used to sing.
And that's my song, it that's our title cut.
So you already saw this.
I already saw this in the future. Yeah. And I'm doing this for the people that they think that I don't have my dreams anymore. I'm going to get a lot of dreams out of the closet. You'll be surprised. I've been people coming up to me in the grocery stores and stores. Every time I walk the streets, ladies, men come to me like, ma'am, I just want to tell you, I was about to give up. Yeah. I had lost all hope. But I saw you on that TV, and I saw you tell your real age. And it was like, hey, I ain't ashamed no more.
Yeah.
And my dreams are gonna come true. And I tell them, yes, come on and go ride with this journey with me together. And then we gonna make yours come true too.
I know that. Well, I love you. I appreciate
Thank you.
And we are with you. Love you.
Yes, love you. Make sure you guys follow me on Instagram, I am Regina Love, and on my Twitter, I am Regina Love. Make sure you tweet. You gotta also tweet daily, you guys. I
daily.
Need you.
Vote
daily.
Tweet,
you
daily.
Gotta vote when the All voting time it. Process comes. And I also need you to buy my iTunes on the Apple Music app or the iTunes app.